We are living through a truly crazy time in America, and every once in a while, we like to take a moment and ask, how did we get here? In a segment called, How Did We Get Here? It's Black History Month, yay! Every morning this month, I wake up and look to see what's waiting for me under the Tubman Tree. Will it be a white person telling me what Martin Luther King would have wanted? Or better yet, someone saying, why do we need a Black History Month? How would you like it if we had a White History Month? You might be thinking that's crazy. The only reason we know about such notable white achievements as Betsy Ross's apparently groundbreaking ability to use a needle and thread or Paul Revere's remarkable ability to scream and ride a horse at the same time is because every month is White History Month. But hear me out. I think we do need a White History Month because the American history that's taught in schools is so whitewashed, we don't learn the real story. We learn lies like George Washington chopping down a cherry tree, but not the fact that George had 18 slaves before he turned 18. 18 slaves. When I was 18, I didn't have 18 shirts. I had 3 shirts and they all looked like this. Each one of them cuter than the last. We learned that Abraham Lincoln said 67 years ago, but not that he said, I am not, nor ever have been, in favor of bringing about in any way the social and political equality of the black and white races. There must be the position of superior and inferior, and I am in favor of having the superior position assigned to the white race. They don't put that on the penny, partially because it would make the penny too long, and partly because our schools don't teach an honest version of American history. And that's why we need White History Month. History shouldn't just be a list of names and dates. It's supposed to give us context for the present. How can we learn about Harriet Tubman and Frederick Douglass and MLK's response to inequality without understanding the true history of the country that enshrined that inequality into law? For example, in regular history, they tell you the Second Amendment was created to protect against tyranny. But during White History Month, you would learn the truth, that the right to bear arms was added to the Constitution so white men could keep their slaves in check. That is a true fact. See how much we're learning? White History Month is fun! I hope you're taking notes in your White History Month trapper keeper. See, at the time the Constitution was written, most states required every able-bodied man who lived there to serve on a slave patrol. These states had posses of white men to keep black people in line. And in the 1700s, they didn't have the kind of advanced adhesive technologies we have now. So slaves couldn't wear name tags. So the slave patroller guys just stopped every black person. Over time, those slave patrols eventually evolved into militias, and during the Revolutionary War, those militias became the American Army. And when the war ended, America had a bunch of roving bands of men who had guns, so they put those men in charge of putting down slave rebellions. And eventually, they put them in charge of enforcing all the laws, or as they called it back then, policing. If you're still taking notes, I bet your trapper keeper just exploded. Now, when the Southern states decided they'd rather own human beings than be part of America, these militias became the Confederate Army. And after the Civil War, the militias came back home with nothing to do. So a few of them started a fun fraternity called the Circle of Brothers. Now, you've probably never heard of the Circle of Brothers fraternity because they always lost at the homecoming step shows. Plus, they used their Greek name, Kuklos, meaning circle, and of course, clan, meaning family. You call them the Ku Klux Klan. That's who enforced racial terrorism during Reconstruction. That's who used violence to enforce Jim Crow laws. That's who carried out the lynchings during the Red Summer of 1919. Google it! That's who still stops and frisks black people at 10 times the rate of white people. That's who still shoots and kills unarmed black citizens at 3.5 times the rate of whites. Because for most of America's history, there's been no difference between the Klan, the police, and plain old racists. So why don't we all know this? Because while Southern men were busy forming the KKK, Southern women were busy forming a fun club called the United Daughters of the Confederacy. The United Daughters joined school boards and formed lobbying groups to make textbooks more favorable to Confederates. And they got so powerful that textbook publishers had to get their approval before school boards agreed to purchase social studies books, ensuring that their version of history is the one that got taught in schools. So now you have to learn the real version from a comedy show. It is impossible to understand politics, the black community's relationship with the police, or why we even need to say Black Lives Matter if we don't learn the history of this country. So yes, let's have a White History Month. Let's have 12 of them. Otherwise, we'll never learn information that's crucial to understanding our own country. Like the fact that once upon a time, there were slave patrols who became militias, who became Revolutionary Army, who became the police, who became the Confederate Army, who became the KKK. Just because they don't teach that in schools doesn't mean you can't learn it. But you're gonna need a lot more trapper keepers. This has been How Did We Get Here?